Wanted to make two quick points. One is that, we have talked of wrongful prosecutions and functional rights, but what has been my experience is that it was the same experience in Delhi. And I'm talking in the context of five to five. We are looking at empowering high courts, the constitutional courts, and the Supreme Court is giving judgments. But unfortunately, we have not strengthened and empowered trial court judges. And you see more and more, that it's a very rare case where you will see enforcement of rights by trial courts, But they're so bogged down with either the level of the case, the nature of the allegations, whether be it sedition, whether it be preventive security, whether it be UAPA, whether it be NDPS, that the rights, the fundamental rights that we are talking of, the procedural requirements are really getting buried by the overwhelming nature of the allegations, And it is very necessary to empower trial court judges to rise above their reluctance and their fear of looking beyond and ensuring securing the rights of accused persons. I keep telling trial court judges wherever I go that there can be peace only if there is justice, and we have to ensure justice. I have said this, Professor Mohan Gopal, when he was at the Judicial Academy, he used to do a wonderful session. He used to do a session on relevance of the constitutional values in the context of trial courts, and I learned so much from this session. And I found that when I was discussing this issue with trial court judges, very few of them could relate to how they work constitutional values in the courtrooms. So I had to remind them of D.K. Basu and an accused being produced before them, and their responsibility of checking his handcuffs, his physical health, his legal aid, whether he was on a level playing field with the prosecution and adequately represented. And when I reminded the trial court judges as to whether they knew of any other place where they could ensure the rights of the accused, everybody was blank. And I reminded them of the lockup in the court premises where under trial spent even the whole entire day waiting for their case to be called. And when I took the trial court judges who were in the session where I was at to the lockup, they saw how many rights were being violated, in terms of food, in terms of the conditions, in terms of hygiene. And we were able to work on lockups in Delhi in a big way. So what my request to my Professor Mohan Gopal and all the learned judges is that we need to work with a vengeance of the trial courts. And what Mr. Hemachandran has said, that we need to emphasize use of technology. Be it the COVID-19 situation has thrown up the need for empowering trial courts and technology. We've talked of e-filing in the Supreme Court, e-filing in the High Court, virtual courts, but there are several courts where there's trial courts where there's no e-connectivity even. So, we need to ensure that we put in mechanisms that, the largest sufferer as of now in the COVID-19 situation has been in terms of deprivation of constitutional rights, have been people, women who are in domestic violence situations, and second is the criminal justice system. It's impossible to get witnesses to appear, very difficult, and very few trial courts have the wherewithal to do virtual trials, with a defense lawyer in some place, ensuring the constitutional rights of the accused, that the trial must take place in the presence of
Justice.
So this is extremely imperative that we look at empowering our trial courts. And I remember Professor Mohan Gopal saying all the time that it is competencies which need to be skilled, which have to be built. And we need to look at ensuring these virtual courts, keeping in view where we are placed, because it is those people who are deprived of their Article 21 rights, who are in jail and are under trials for long years, Disruption, I'm seeing disruptions in the court, in trials in Jammu and Kashmir for several long periods. We've had disruptions since August last year. So, the lockdown hasn't come as much of a surprise here. But despite the problems, we've kept courts going, but we still haven't been able to ensure trials to proceed. And this is a very, very huge gap. I'm taking this opportunity. I see there's so many people who have joined this program, Professor Mohan Gopal, and we really need to take this conversation further. And I'm sure you will be able to address it. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, ma'am, for as always a very